Hi everybody, this is Elizabeth with Live Simple, Live Free. And I've got a neat unboxing to share with you. Here we go. So I have received my box now from Lev HaOlam. It's the subscription service that I have. It is from Israel. The name Lev HaOlam means heart of the world. And I've been on the subscription service. This really helps the families, farmers, artists, craftsmen, craftspeople in the central kind of heart of Israel, in Samaria, Judea, to be able to have a market for their goods. And I have really enjoyed it. So I always like to just wait and open it and share it with you guys so that you can, you know, share this, the fun unboxing with me. So, all right, I'm gonna open this. It's always so much fun when I get it. They're all different and they usually have a theme. So we'll see. There we go. All right. Very carefully close my cute little knife here. There we go. All right. Okay. This says freedom. Let my people go. Moses' brave and determined call for freedom echoes to this very day in the beating heart of all humanity, appealing to all who are in conscious and mental slavery. Leave behind the places that constrict you. Move forward towards freedom. So that was like the first paper that was in there. All right, let's see what we have this time. Oh, I love the olive oil. I have used it and used it. I'm always grateful to get the good olive oil from them. It's extra virgin cold press. Let me see if I can get the name in English here. Hatsav Farm. The story of all of them are so interesting. There, and there'll be a little book in here that'll tell me about all these different craftspeople and the farmers and everything. Thousands of years of ancient Jewish settlement across the Golan Heights left behind clear markings of a highly developed agriculture alongside synagogues and houses of learning. Ancient oil presses pepper the landscape, attesting to the robust olive oil industry that once existed here. The last 50 years have witnessed a renewal of the agricultural industry on the Golan Heights by Jewish settlers who work the land, continuing in the footsteps of their ancestors by producing quality of olive oil and wine. So this, the Hatsav Farm was founded by Yaakov and Tamar Heinemann. I'm so sorry, I know I don't pronounce everything right. In the town of Nov, adjacent to the ancient Jewish settlement Ein Keshato, the Spring of the Arches, which was home to a beautiful synagogue, wine presses and oil presses used to make olive oil. So on our label appears one such oil press in all of its glory. So yeah, they've got the oil press on the front. It's usually, every bit of olive oil I've ever gotten from Lev HaOlam has been wonderful to use, so I like getting that. The red spice, Judean spices. Wow, this mixture of spices was inspired by the red stew that Jacob cooked and used to purchase the right of the firstborn from his brother Esau. This mixture consists of Israelis, Judean mountains, it consists of herbs of Israelis, Judean mountains mixed with spices of the Far East that arrived here in the time of Jacob on the spice route from the Far East to the land of Canaan. It's an excellent seasoning for roast chicken, potatoes, and any Middle Eastern style dish. Oh, yum. Okay. So, Judean spices, 100% natural. I just want to see what it smells like. Ooh, yum. Ooh, you can tell it's got kind of a. Oh, what is that smell? It's really nice. You can tell it's going to have some real spiciness to it, but I'm smelling something in there. It's a wonderful combination of herbs and pepper and za'atar. Oh yeah, that's going to be very nice seasoning. Night cream, our God. Oh, I love their stuff. I've gotten quite a bit of their stuff. Night cream, snowflake. And Chris, this is all written in Hebrew, all on this part of it. Night cream, anti-aging for healthy, energized skin. It is everything nature can offer for your skin. Flower extracts, herbal plants for healthy-looking skin. This revitalizing night cream with highly concentrated ingredients for deep and effective overnight treatment and complex vitamins to keep your skin fresh and vibrant. I've had the stuff from the Arugot, Arugot before, and it's organic, vegan, and I've loved their stuff. Oh wow, this is nice. Doesn't irritate my skin. It's very, very nice stuff. Okay. Oh, more from Aragot. And this is the Snowflake Day Cream. That's good. The last one I've gotten from them that I've been using on my face is starting to get used up. So this is really great timing. Very, very mild. I'm putting on a little different place here. Oh, what a delicate, nice floral scent that is. So, aren't these beautiful? Just they're packaged very nicely, very easy to use. That's going to be great. Oh, yes. Dark chocolate covered almonds. 70% dark chocolate covered almonds. From Holy Cacao. I've gotten stuff from them too before. Bean to bar chocolate. Very, very natural, organic. Holy Cacao has been crafting award-winning chocolates since 2008 in the heartland of Israel, right next to Hebron. We source cacao directly from farmers all over the world, paying premium prices for the best quality. The taste of our chocolate reflects the hard work put in by our partners in the fields and factories, and are proud to offer you Israel's premier bean to bar chocolate made in Judea and Samaria. Oh, those are gonna be good. Okay. Passover. Oh, wow, yeah, the timing. This is like my March box. And so, yeah, the timing would be for Passover. There's usually a theme. Let me see here. Oh, I might have to use my knife again. No, I got it. In every generation, a person must regard himself as though he personally had gone out of Egypt. So this is like, oh, it's probably going to be a great big map. And what their journey was. A map of the Exodus. That could be very, very interesting. Wow. And then it says, to find out the true secret of the Exodus, open here. This is the Warsaw Ghetto in 1941. The true secret of freedom is to be found within memory. There's a picture here of a Jewish family on the eve of Passover during the Holocaust. For thousands of years, the Jewish people carries the memory of the Exodus from Egypt. Every Sabbath festival, and particularly on Passover, the family gathers to retell the Exodus and to cultivate the aspiration for freedom and the return to the land of Israel. In Zechariah 8, 4 and 5, this is what God says. There will be a time when old men and old women sit in the streets of Jerusalem, every man with his staff in his hand at an old age, and the streets of the city shall be full of boys and girls playing. And of course, here's a picture now of Jerusalem in 2021. The with all the people just out on the streets. That is so cool. You know, something like what happened in the Holocaust, we can never forget. It's very important, you know, very wise saying that, I think, Santayana, he who does not remember the past is doomed to repeat it. And we want to remember, that's for sure. So that's pretty interesting. I'll look that all over. And all the different places that they went when they did the Exodus from Egypt. And you know, the Passover was called that because the Lord had them take the blood of a lamb and put it over their doors and have a special meal that night and be very ready to go. And when the angel of death came as the final plague in Egypt and killed the eldest, the firstborn of every family, the angel did not come to their homes because there was the blood of the lamb over the doorway. And that's such a powerful image because we can be protected from the penalty of destruction and death because of the blood of the lamb, and that's Jesus. Okay, so this is all about the Exodus and Moses, and they'll you know, give information about what's going on in Israel, and the different farms and the different people where all these things come from, and recipes. And I should try red spice roast chicken with potato wedges and just try some of the recipes. These little booklets are really interesting. All right. Oh Yum matzo bread, chocolate coated matzo. That is going to be very good. I can't eat it, but I think Bill's going to enjoy it. Yep. Yum. So it's matzo bread, which is very traditional, you know, Israeli food, and it's covered in chocolate. Yeah, somebody wants to try that. Okay. There's usually something from an artist. This is a handcrafted ceramic bowl. Oh, man. I bet this is going to be beautiful. Cool. I'll make sure you get to see it. Devorah, I can't pronounce her last name. Yechezgeli. Sorry, I can't quite pronounce it, but she's a designer and a ceramicist in the settlement of Kfar Adumim, a small village in the Judean desert overlooking the magnificent Wadi of Nahal Prat. So my days are a bustling mix of caring for my children, alongside frequent visits to my studio located just down the street from my home. So I carry out the ceramic process through all of the stages. Each one of these, even though the ones I make are similar, each one is unique and intended especially for the person who will receive it. Aww. Look at this. Wrapped very carefully. Oh, that's lovely. It's just handcrafted. There's a pattern on the back, on the bottom of it. Just a handcrafted, just lovely little bowl. Oh, that's so pretty. Beautifully done. Oh, that's so lovely. Hold it up kind of closer to the camera for me, hon. What are you thinking of that matzah with chocolate on it? Oh, that's so pretty.
Chocolate covered matzo, not matzo, what's it?
It's matzo. You should have the package there, matzo.
Matzo bread.
Yes.
Good stuff. This is the second time we've gotten this.
Yeah, I know you
I think the very first box we got.
Yeah, I think the very first one we got had that in there. The boxes all vary. In fact, I've discovered that month by month they vary to different people, which is really fun. This was my one for March. So, oh, neat. Okay, some lovely lotion that I'm going to definitely be using. Oil I can use in that beautiful little bowl. Oh. And good stuff to learn about. I'm going to enjoy looking that map over and reading the little book and everything. So, well, that was my unboxing for this box from Lev Ha'olam for March. And I will have a link below. If you're interested in finding out more about Lev Heil Lama, it's pretty easy to find. I'm just like everybody else. I enjoy getting them. I pay full price. I'm very glad to do it. Very glad to support these families and these businesses. But I'm just glad to share it with you. Unboxings are just fun anyway. I watch them myself. So, all right. Well, thank you for joining with me today. And you guys be blessed. Remember to live simple, live free. And I love you. I will see you soon. Okay, bye-bye.